fire. Yes, from around the world, across the nation, and
up your street, it's your rave relay, DJ Jive, talking and live walking you through this week's world charts.
That's right. It's time to strobe the globe, scan the lands, delve on the shelves, and split the hits that are twisting the listings right across the world tonight. So, let's start with a rundown of the top 30. And right in there at number 30 is South Africa with a double cider with those two great crowd songs, Hit Me With Your Policeman Stick and
Get Me to the Hospital on Time.
And straight in at number 29, another double whammer and a first-time entry from Russia, way out in front on style, once again with We're Young, Hip, and Crazy.
Isn't it bad?
And still at number 28, it's Poland with Gdansk, Gdansk. So good they named it, twice.
And straight in at number 15, it's Iceland,
following their recent 11-inch. That was a mammoth hit in Iceland. Fish soup, glorious fish soup.
And what a day for fish soup.
They're now up there again with You Say Herring, I Say Cod.
Let's call the whole thing bouillabaisse.
Those Icelanders write some beautiful songs. And still riding high on 14, it's Czechoslovakia with that Chuck Berry sound. Cruising along in my tractor. And at number 13, it's the contest big sound from Japan. I've got a brand new pair of horn rim specs. And the big one storming up five places to number one, top of the world this week. The South African version of a Paul McCartney song, a beautiful anthem to beautiful South Africa, Ivory and Ivory. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, I'm going to dedicate this show to you. Okay? Because truly, I'm in love with you. I really am. I'm in love with everyone who's watching tonight. And I feel I know that we're growing closer as each day goes by, and I'm caught up in the middle of a deeply emotional affair with every single last one of you beautiful, beautiful people. Even if you're Belgian.
I love you.
Sincerity. You can't buy it.
I don't know. You can rent it cheap, though.
It was 6 o'clock. I hadn't had a drink since 7. Either I was drawing out or my watch had stopped. My hand started shaking, but my watch still wouldn't start.
I know what I need.
A shot.
A shot in the
ear. Acupuncture. At 3 a.m., I arrived at the surgery.
I used the term loosely.
It was actually more like 3:30. A tiny oriental scrap of humanity motioned me to sit on a bit of squalid rush matting. When I sat on his leg by mistake, I knew I was in trouble.
He asked if anything was disturbing me.
I said, nothing. When he rammed a needle in my ear, I said I was disturbed. After 2 needles, I lost the use of both legs. After 4, I lost the use of my car, swimming pool, and tennis courts. After
6,
I noticed that the yellow devil picked up Chinese satellite TV on his deaf aid. It was time to go. I hated Chinese TV, and my books were due back at the library.
But that's another story, and another accent.
Dress you up, show you up,
It's time for a trip down memory lane.
Do you remember this?
And this?
About this.
Nope. Yeah, neither do I. I don't know where they came from.
We've now come to a very exciting moment for us all in our weekly Choose Your Favorite Adverts competition. Because I'm delighted to tell you that of the literally thousands of entries, this week's winning suggestions come from no less than Her Royal Highness, the Queen Mother. And so, we are now very pleased, proud, and honored to present to you the Queen Mother's favorite advertisements. Unmistakable, isn't it? Who could fail to recognize the sweet and gentle garboing, garboing of Chinese music? Yes, I am in China, one of the most remarkable countries in the world. A nation rich in ancient monument, treasure, and bicycle repair shop. And how Chinese love their bike. Ring a ding go their bicycle bell, and ding a ring a ring a ring go their birth certificate.
And they don't just use them for work.
No! At weekends, you'll see them skillfully racing their bikes across wet paddy fields, falling off, laughing, and saying, "Variety, Ariat," like only the Chinese can. And that's because the Chinese love a challenge. And isn't that why they all wore dull old uniforms? Because that dribbly soy sauce was always running down their chins and ruining their best clothes?
Such a clever race.
My boots are itchy in the square that's wrapped.
Why not? Can't dance and it's too wet to plow.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Mr. Oliver, I refuse to lose weight for this part. Greene! Woo!
Ollie,
yeah.
I'm a bit wary because you have the reputation of being a
tough guy. Is that what you are?
No, I think that's the press has given me that image. I'm really a pussycat. It is very difficult for me to be able to walk outside and trip over a banana skin without people thinking, of course, I'm going to inject something that is violent into society. No, I'm not. I'm not a violent fellow. I have played violent parts, but as you know, there are all sorts of things in the astral plane that one is misjudged for.
Okay, here's a quick headbutt. The Devils. Bit of a strong film, and it hasn't been allowed on a TV, but I liked it.
What do you think about censorship of films like that?
I think censorship changes from decade to decade. When we made The Devils, for instance, it was barred in, along with Women in Love in Italy. And it wasn't until such time as The Devils and Women in Love, The Devils more specifically, were shown at the Venice Film Festival that it was allowed to be shown in Italy. And then the whole idea changed. For instance, I just made a movie where I had to take my clothes off at this age, which probably 20 years ago would not have been allowed. All I think is that I would much prefer to see nudity than chopping up people.
Hmm. Okay. Well, that's. I think that's a...
So many good ideas are given to violent children who are on drugs if you don't censor the methods by which somebody can be raped or the entry that one can make into a house. I believe in that kind of censorship. I'm not sure that there's anything too shameful about nudity.
Hmm. Your nude wrestling scene with Ellen Bates, such you mentioned, in Women in Love, it's become a bit of a classic, hasn't it?
Yeah, we never recognized it as that. The only thing that Alan Bates and I were rather shy about taking our clothes off because, there again, coming back to censorship, that was made, I suppose, 18, 19 years ago, and actors in those days in legitimate films didn't take their clothes off.
Right.
I.e. art films, sure, but I mean, let's face it, Lawrence had only been just taken off a pornographic list in the late 50s. Other than that, he'd been regarded as a pornographer. So Alan and I got very frightened about taking our clothes off, but that was cured by a bottle of vodka each. And the room was very cold, and the firelight was made with what is called a dingleberry, with the assistance of a lot of people from the film crew.
A dingleberry?
A dingleberry, which is a...
Is that like a buffalo chip?
No, it sounds like something that you have in your head. I know it's a buffalo chip. What chips do you use in your head?
No, they're just sort of standard computer chips. I like them with everything.
As I walk along, I wonder what went wrong with our love. A love that was so strong. And as I still walk on, I think of the things we've done.
Let's just grip arms and kind of push each other around the old ring a bit and ask you about S-P-O-R-T, sport. Huh. You used to be a bit of an all-around champion as a youngster, as you said. Now, could you have made it big as a sportsman, do you figure? Ollie?
Mm-hmm.
Still there?
Yeah. Do you know, I loathe the arrogance of sportsmen. Shall I tell you why, Max?
Okay.
Because if I went into a pub and say, yeah, I could have been a prize fighter.
Mm. Well, yeah, and so he's going to come up and sort of go take out, a swing at you.
The first
stuff,
thing
yeah.
that happens, sorry, we're going to both speak at once.
No, you go ahead.
Then the first thing that would happen, people would have got into competition or will get into competition with it. That used to happen in the old days because people are always talking about me in terms of violence, about falling down. The next thing, because you want to be avant-garde, is to talk about sexuality. So coming back to violence at the cost of you falling asleep. I don't... Yes, I could have been...
I think it's incredible the way you can tie any subject to anything. You're amazing.
Yeah, well, I'm at the moment trying to tie it to sport. I could have been... In reality, I think I could have gone some distance in sport.
Right, but you kind of got limited by the old showbiz thing of... no contact sports on the weekend because we got a film on a Monday.
That's it.
Right.
That's
okay. Well, let's get back to rugby a bit. You know, with the lads and the bath and 15 pints and a quick chorus of If I Were the Marrying Kind and the hairs on my dicky do. Love that stuff. But is it the game or being with the lads like Alan Bates that you like so much?
No. Alan Bates has one like a pigeon's egg.
He has one like a pigeon's egg?
Yeah.
One what?
One hell of an ego.
That the only thing that gets any exercise these days is your liver?
No, that's not true. I had that checked out by my doctor.
Everything okay there?
Everything's right on.
None of that Swiss cheese stuff for you.
No, Max.
Okay.
Because I was just asking that sort of stuff, because a little bird with its little beak and a little sling told me you have a very short temper. Should I be sorry I said that?
No, Max, you shouldn't. You understand right now with your bright eyes that I'm a very cool dude.
Mean
rook. And I'm a cool dude.
Okay, you are a countryman at heart. Now, what do you think about blood sports? I mean, I never ask biased questions, but do you like blasting birds out of the sky, dragging fish out of rivers, scaring the wits out of poor little foxes? That sort of thing.
No.
Okay, films. I said we'd come back now to nudity, because you recently made the film Castaway.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Okay, well, I was involved with this. I was involved with that film about a year and a half ago when Nicholas Rogan was going to make it as a director, and then it was going to be financed by Virgin Records, and then Virgin fell out, and then EMI Thorn took over, and then EMI Thorn was bought out by an Australian, and within 1 week the Australian was bought out by Cannon. I thought the girl was very good, and I thought it was a marvellous part, and I admire Nicholas Rogan, and it was jolly good, and we made it for about $2.25 million or dollars, and which is jolly good, and I don't know either if it's a dollar and the pound fluctuate, but meantime I thought it was great. It's a story about a man and a woman, a true story about a fellow that goes off to a desert island with a girl, makes love to her for the first 1 month, and then she gives him a biggie, which means denies him his sexual desires or the nuptial rights, and then right at the end they have a big thunderstorm, she gives him one, and then she flies off home.
See, that wasn't glib. It's really very good. You took your time, you paused.
Well, I didn't want to waste yours, Max.
Ollie, you are great, buddy. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to say I've just achieved an honorable draw with Oliver Reed. Ollie, thanks for coming. Oliver Reed, something big enough. Woo! Woo! Clap, 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 clap. Yes, quiz is the game that takes no time to play and almost no intelligence. So, what's the prize tonight? They're well trained, aren't they? Well, tonight's star prize is an all-expenses-paid trip for two lucky people to spend a night in Las Vegas to see the Boomtown Rats in concert. Then, to meet your idols and spend the evening with them. Okay, our simple question is, and the first person to shout out the answer wins, who is the Boomtown Rats lead singer? Come on, think! The Boomtown Rats in concert! Okay, we're going to save the great prize for another time. And say goodnight!
And this one's for the guys.
Okay. Listen, don't try to tell lies
with your aftershave.
If your fragrance is bullhorn or rhino stab or whiff of mating
or
rutting season, and you're trying to say, hey, baby, this is a real man.
I'm not surprised you're getting nowhere. You see, those aren't fragrances. They are odors.
They are riot control weapons. They are the stuff they fire at charging rhinos, and it doesn't work on them either.
And women are not that easily fooled. They know it's just a cover-up.
Cover-up? They know if you wear a rutting weapon, that says you'd rather be at home stir-frying alfalfa.
Or feeding the fish.
Or reading the inner self. They know if you were really the knuckle-dragging primate type, you wouldn't admit it. You'd be trying to look sensitive, wearing Rodin, or Caravaggio, or Wordsworth. So listen,
dud throb.
Women know that when you're at a party smelling like a grizzly's gout bandage, you are not the all-male, hairy-chested, bristle-chinned stud they're looking for. And how do they know?
Because he's over there, smelling like a daffodil.
Or you could do what I do and just wear boink, 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 boink. Hi. Hi. How long have we known each other? Oh, we've got way back. You know, we've never sung a song together. You know, that's true. Maybe we better put that right. Not time like the present, big fella. You know this one? Are you kidding? Grab a line. Try to hang on. We're just good pals. That's right. Ain't got no time for gals. You're the one I rely on, like Reichard under nylon. We laugh, we have fun.
We sure do.
We're like the double barrel of a gun. We go together like days and nights, like legs in the same pair of tights.
You enjoying this?
Since I don't know when.
Carry on?
Don't try and stop me. We're just good pals.
That's
no time for Susie or Sal. We're a couple of machos, far too butch to watch chat shows. Well, football, that's okay. We share a beer, that's our way. Did you know you're my oldest mate?
You old reprobate. Say that again.
I've seen your style. It sticks out a mile. We sit on a couple of stools, pal, but we ain't a couple of tools, pal. I love you in blues, like I bought you for that cruise. Remember that night on B-deck when you wore my leather V-neck. But we're butch, we're straight. We go to bed about 8 and sleep in separate rooms.
That's right,
and we don't see each other all night. I like your style. It sticks out a mile.
A mile?
We sit on a couple of stools, pal, but we ain't a couple of tools, pal.
One more?
You lead.
Tag along.
I'm with you. We share a flat, you set. I steal the duvet off your bed. I'll do anything he asks, but I won't wear studded leather.
Or
masks. I could talk to you for an hour.
Me too.
I love to hear you sing in the shower. I might give you a couple of friendly slaps, but we're just normal chaps.
Well, we are.
Don't slink around in silk wraps. Don't share our shower caps. Don't pose for no weirdo snaps.
Well, that's right.
Or sit on each other's lap.
No, sir.
Yes, we're just good pals.
That's right.
Underissus act. When my neurodibaterian climaxin cut. God! I'm wetting myself! Hello, my wonderful, wonderful friends. And I've been looking forward to this moment for, minutes.